Mr. Paperton. First time I saw him, I was sitting at a Starbucks, you know, sipping a short drip.
Some alien poster paper. You know, I wasn't really sure about it at first.
It's a good thing he came down from the moon. And I feel this little tap on my shoulder, you know, I thought it was someone I knew or an old colleague. No, it turns out it's this little sheet of paper.
Had like this really white glow about him, which is kind of nice, you know?
But then it came to me that he was in fact a real piece of paper, and he was blank, you know? He had this sad look on his face.
He had like no self-esteem whatsoever.
It was quite a shocker at first, but I grew fond of the idea.
And he's like, you know, paint me, color me. Give me some life. So it just popped into my head, like I need to find my guys.
Kelly saw the good in him.
We all hit it off with the band real fast.
Turned out he'd been in a lot of my favorite books, actually. He'd been in a couple screenplays I really enjoyed.
Except for Michael, he was a little slow. And he was just a but I think it would be Padres, Noah West, gunslinging.
We all came together and,
you know what? Now we're homies.
Fun to be around, really. Just a joy.
Angelic, you know?
Quite the lady killer now. I mean, just knocks him dead.
You are not a dick, like most people said.
Does anybody know what Paperton is?
Paperton.
He really hates fire. Just hates it.
I wanna just give my sincere utmost gratitude for your great attitude.
I wanna play some pinball with him. Maybe go for a swim.
The passion out of that paper is really amazing.
Mr. Paperton, in the process of finding yourself and completing your true identity and your true life, you've actually completed all of our lives and added so much joy and wonder to this world.
I thank Mr. Paperton.
Thank you, Mr. Paperton.
Thank you, Paperton.
Mr. Paperton, you're a true hero.